cleaning your better press magnetic insert and your better press plates. We suggest a lint-free cloth. So this is a kind of a dish towel that is lint-free, or you could use lint-free paper towels. And we also suggest the archival ink cleaner from Ranger. Really works the best on the type of ink that we are using for our better press. If I'm ready to clean my plate, you can use it quite a few times, maybe 10 to 12 times before having to clean it. But I would bring my plate to my cloth, apply some ink cleaner. I just kind of dab it on. Rubbing motion could kind of scratch the little felt pad on top of your cleaner. So I just dab. And then after I've applied the ink cleaner, I will just come in with a towel and rub the ink away until it comes quite clean. If there is a little bit of ink left, you can put a little bit more cleaner on certain spots. And when you're satisfied that your plate is clean, there may be a little bit of the oily residue from the archival ink cleaner. So you could take your plate to the sink and wash it with mild dish soap and water. When I do clean my magnetic insert, I do not want to apply the ink cleaner directly to the insert. Rather, I'll dab some on my towel and then use that to come to my insert and rub away the ink. Again, it won't come perfectly clean, but you will get the majority of the ink off and you'll be all set and ready to go for your next project. When I prep my card panel to do what I call a normal better press plate, or in other words, a single image, I go ahead and bring my cotton paper in and I line it up with the corresponding registration marks. So this would be for an A2 card. And then using the best over craft tape, I just put a small little corner on each edge of the A2 panel. And that's gonna hold it perfectly in place to match the A2 registration here. So when I go to add my ink, then my paper will go on top and it'll be perfectly lined up. When I'm prepping my cotton card panel for a larger plate, one that's at least A2 or even larger, I realize that I don't want to have tape at the corners of my cotton panel. Instead, I will come in with a best over craft tape and create just a small little roll of tape. And I'll do one of those in each corner of my cotton card panel. Now I will do the same thing with the registration, line it up so it all matches. And now you'll see there's no tape showing. So when I do the inking and I go ahead and do my press plate, it will line up perfectly and not have any tape interfering with the inking process. I have my better press plate all inked up. Now I'm going to go to bring the platen, which already has my cotton paper on it, to my machine. I'm gonna gently pop it on the magnetic springs. And now as I bring the chase over to my die cutting machine, I'm gonna be careful not to push down on this at all. I don't want any ink going on the paper before I'm ready. So I'm going to hold the platform, the chase down here on the bottom, just trying to avoid touching the clear plastic at all until I'm ready to run it through. And I can gently guide it with my hand again holding at the bottom of the chase and then run it through my die cutting machine. Pull your beautiful print off, you'll see that there's no excess ink anywhere that I don't want it to be, just because I was a little extra careful running the platform through my die cutting machine. It's very useful to have the grids on the better press magnetic insert. I can use these grids to move my plate and get it in exactly the right position. You can use the back side of a tweezer if you want and kind of get it adjusted. It's especially helpful for sentiments. When I go in and want to put my sentiment, I can use the grid and make sure that it's perfectly straight, exactly how I want it to be lined up. And then I can double check the outline of my A2 card and see that it's exactly where I want it to be. Some of our better press plates have smaller items that could be die cut when you're finished doing your better press. So I want to give you a little tip on die cutting those. This is one that I already have done. The sentiment is able to die cut and pop it up on the card like you see here. So here's a tip for die cutting. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my die cutting plates. If your plates have a lot of marks on them, this one's not even terribly bad, but a lot of your plates, as is normal with die cutting, will have different marks on the plate from your previous dies that you've used. That is perfectly fine for the bottom. But because this cotton paper is so squishy, I'll call it, remember it's got that nice thick cotton quality to it. It's very easy to leave an impression on it, which is why it makes such a great paper for better pressing. But if I were to put a marked up plate on top of this, as I run it through my die cutting machine, it would definitely leave some marks. So what I suggest is grab one of your new plates or pick up a new set. I have this one that I actually keep pristine in the packaging for in case this one gets marred up. But grab something that's brand new and use that as your top plate when you go in to do die cutting. That way you're not going to transfer any marks from your die cutting plate to your BetterPress panel. Because my top plate is nice and clean, I'm not transferring any marks to my BetterPress die cut.